I'm going to piggyback some things that Scott was just going over, because I think this is core to the work that we have done with One Bite Off the Lounge, particularly the feedback that we got from the consultant. Times truly have changed. As he said, I think most of us are, we've got a few gray hairs anyway, and we did it just as Scott talked about. We got done with whatever we were doing, and we found a job, and that's where we made our life. One of the things when I got to Valdosta State that folks started saying to me right off the bat was, you know, we love Valdosta State. We know it has a massive economic impact on this community, et cetera, but we wish more of your graduates, you know, when they got done finishing their programs, that they stayed here, that they didn't pack up the car and move to Atlanta or Orlando or wherever. And as we've dug into this, and this is really an issue across rural America, it's certainly an issue in South Georgia, that we have been working at Valdosta State trying to help our communities through our Center for South Georgia Regional Impact think about how do they be successful in the long term. And economic development, as Scott said, has truly changed. It has moved to a model where, yeah, you still need the spec building, you still need those things, but every time that I get invited by Andrea and others to come and talk to prospective businesses, what they want to know is they want to know about talent, and they want to know about quality of life. Frankly, that's all the questions that we get is what kind of talent generation process do we have here? Will they stay here? Will they go to work? And then will we retain them through quality of life? And what we see increasingly, and we saw this certainly in the last 10 years, is that younger folks when they think about where they want to live, they want to move to a metropolitan area. They want the energy and the vibe that comes with that. And why? Well, they're looking for certain things in communities. They start with they want a vibrant downtown. They want green space. They want diversity. They want a whole other bunch of folks that look like them, that they can hang out with and that they can spend time with. All of that for them is quality of life. That's how they define it. And so much, as Scott has alluded to, of this plan and the work that we have done has really been to think about how, not how do we make it move away from a place that we all enjoy to live. The fact is you can keep those things, but how do you have that kind of community and also a place that the younger generation want to be? Certainly, my hope is that the 1,000-plus students that will walk across the stage come December and again in May, that the vast majority of them will want to stay local, and we're trying to make a community here that they want to do that in an increasing way. So, as Scott said, we got a unanimous vote from the members of the steering committee to move forward with trying to write an addendum to the work that Vision First had done. We think certainly COVID was a pause, but we came out of COVID knowing that we had economic conditions that had changed. And so we had to really think about how would we be successful in a post-COVID world, and I think ultimately it's led to a better plan. You heard Scott say that one of the things that our community business leaders didn't like in the original plan, they liked a lot of things, but one of the things they did not like was they did not like the vision statement that had been crafted. And so working together, the members of the steering committee came up with a new vision, and that is to be a united and forward-thinking community. And they wrote a new tagline with that to say that we are all in. Now, I think that's really, really important, this idea of all in. Because if we remember and we think about what Scott said of Georgia Power's first forays into this idea of a community plan, it started really with a perception that our entities, our major entities in this community, did not work together. And so what did they do? In fact, when they had worked in other communities, they usually had worked with a single entity. They had come to the city, or they'd come to the county, or they'd come to the chamber or the development board, usually one of those four, and they had worked specifically with them. But they thought that in order for this community to move forward and to fully maximize its potential, the way to do that was to do an all-in plan. It's why they started by coming to the city and the county and saying, hey, we'll do this if you're both in. And the answer was yes, and we worked with leadership at that time. Then they went to the Chamber and the Development Authority, and they did the same thing as you heard. So as we move through this process, another thing that certainly the members of the steering committee and members of the business community thought could be improved in the draft plan that Vision First did was what was the long-term home for One Valdosta Lounge. Vision First, in their plan that they had drafted, actually called for the creation of a new freestanding organization. It would be a member membership-driven organization, and that's how it would be funded operationally. But certainly, as we got together and we started talking, we thought it made more sense to house it with an existing entity. And as we have new chamber leadership in this community, there was excitement to that, there was excitement to that leadership, and the belief was that the chamber made sense, given its business mission, et cetera, to be the new home, again, under that leadership. And so what this plan now allows for is the hiring of a director that would be a chamber employee, would work under the leadership of the chamber CEO and president, and that there would also be an advisory board, half of which would be made up of public sector officials, half of which would be made up of the business community, the leaders from the business community. And that group together would advise and direct the work of One Valdosta Lounge going forward as an entity, again, of the chamber. One of the big pieces of this was we also talked about the extent to which we talked about how would the projects that we would do get funded. But we understand is that in this community, for whatever reason, for the longest time, you all have had a lot of pressure placed on you to be the folks that got stuff done. Most of the big projects that have happened recently in Valdosta and Lowndes County, the public has looked to our city and our county to get those done. And in fact, other communities that are successful, that's much more a partnership between the city, the county, the public officials, the public entities, and the business community and local foundations. And so what we did was to think about how could we leverage that support going forward. And so one of the first things that the One Valdosta Lounge director and that advisory group would do would be to conduct a feasibility study around a proposed set of projects. And we'll get to those projects in just a second. But essentially what we're doing is we're asking those who might be funders of big projects, hey, what appeals to you? Here's a menu of potential items that we would dive into. What appeals to you? What would you be willing financially to support? And we have multiple examples throughout Georgia of other communities who have gone through very similar processes, have raised considerable funds in order to support big projects. We absolutely think that that same can happen here. And then using the work of that feasibility study, we would ultimately launch a capital campaign to raise, again, the lion's share of the funding to fund the initiatives that are laid out in the plan. So what will this project do? So one of the big things that has come out of the addendum work is that the steering committee members got together with business and community leaders from, again, across Valdosta and Lowndes County, and we looked at a whole host of potential projects in which we could be engaged. And ultimately, again, you heard Scott earlier say that our business leaders felt that the original draft plan was maybe missing what they started to label big wins. And so we looked for some big winning projects that the kinds of things that frankly only could be done through partnership, or at least could best be done through partnership. And so you see here on the slide that we have up here four examples of those big win projects. The first is a project that this group knows very well, and that's the River Camp project, obviously a 1.3-mile stretch where the Little River joins with the Coochie. We have amazing access here in Valdosta and Lowndes County to nature, and yet we don't have natural spaces and easy spaces for our community to enjoy that. You all have done a lot of work on this project for sure, but we think there are opportunities, again, leveraging public support to complete a project and maybe even expand scope of a project as additional funding becomes available. There's been a lot of talk, again, about as we think about the younger generation of how do we continue to expand and improve upon the downtown area. I remember in one of the meetings that we had, we were talking about the need to do this. And somebody said, well, I want to take issue with that because I think we have an amazing downtown, and I happen to think that as well. And I said, well, tell me, I agree with that, so tell me why you say that. And they said, well, I think about First Friday, for example. And my wife and I go down every month on First Friday, and we have dinner, and we have a heck of a time even getting a table because it is so full. So that's kind of the experience my wife and I have as well. But can I ask you a question? The person said, sure. I said, what time do you go? And the person said, oh, about 6:30 or 7. I said, great. I said, and the place that you go, what time does it close? I said, I think 9. I said, okay. What time does a 20-something young professional want to go out? About 9. And oh, by the way, they're probably not in a position to afford the price point that exists in our current downtown. That many of us, we can do that, and we can go down there and have a great time. I was just literally over the weekend spending time with a group of 20-something young professionals that are struggling. They're struggling to find connection in this community. They're former students of VSU. They loved being students at VSU. And so because of that, they wanted to stay here. They wanted to invest. And what they see is this starts to become a really great place for professionals once they start forming a family and getting older. But there's that gap. Again, so we think there are opportunities to try to expand the downtown. And a natural way to do that would be to make real investments between the existing and developed area of Patterson Street and Georgia Beer. Georgia Beer is clearly a tremendous asset for this community. There's actually been a ton of work done by the Department of Labor around what helps communities of our size be successful. And oh, by the way, when they looked at every potential characteristic that you can look at that identifies a successful small city, what they found was web connectivity was number one, and the presence of a microbrew was number two. Why? Because it defines a culture. It sets a culture. And if you can build around that entity, you start to expand the culture that attracts young professionals, again, the talent for the next workforce. We think there are opportunities to do that. The next one listed here is, and I didn't come up with this. This was other members of the steering committee that thought that there was a tremendous potential in capitalizing on the 12,000 students and the 2,500 employees that we have at VSU by better connecting the downtown to VSU, and we could do that through improved pathways, signage, and the like. And then I think many in this group know that the Chamber had been working kind of on a go-it-itself project to think about a new incubator. COVID halted that work and ultimately caused them as a group to think about, was that the best way to do that? And they ultimately determined that probably a better way to do that was in some kind of partnership. I think that was a good decision. Certainly the Chamber would continue to be involved in a major way in that effort. But there's thoughts that VSU's Center for South Georgia Regional Impact could also be involved, or SBDC, through UGA could be involved, and other entities that are all working together to, again, develop the next generation of small businesses and STEM business leaders. Beyond the big projects, there are a whole host of more focused projects that are also laid out in the plan. I'm not going to go through every one of them. But they really do, again, speak to kind of all pieces of how you improve a community. I'll focus on just a couple. One of these, your chairman has actually been a huge advocate for. In fact, I think it's on here because you led the lead to say we needed to have this conversation. And that was, how could we promote youth success? And to really put together a group that would be focused on trying to come up with a plan for how do we tackle that issue? How do we engage the next generation of potential difference makers in our community? Instead of, we know that if we can get them righted at an early age, the cost of the community, et cetera, go down dramatically, the benefits go up. We need a group to be focused on that, and we think, again, One Dot Ostalounds and the partnership effort that exists there is certainly a big way to do that. The Young Professionals Network. This is something that in past years the Chamber had tried to do, and quite frankly, they tried and it didn't work. But again, as I just told you, we've got a group of 20-something professionals here who want to be here, and they're struggling. One idea that we have talked about and we've begun to lay the groundwork for this is that we would put those folks together. We would get behind them, give them support, and help them come up with a plan for how do we move the community forward. A lot of folks know that there has been a similar project across the state where young professionals descend on a community. We thought about one time bringing those folks here to about Austin and Lowndes County. The idea is, why can't we do that ourselves? Why can't we get those folks engaged in giving us ideas about how to improve the community, but also socially connecting them so that they have a home and, again, that they want to be here for the long term. The last thing I'll mention on this list is a top 50 list. It's kind of an easy thing, and yet we don't have that. you can't just in an easy way go to our community, our website here, and find out if you're somebody who lives here or if you're coming in as a tourist. What do I do? How do I get involved? And what is there to enjoy in this community? Again, it's everything from those easy projects to the hard projects that happen when we come together and we have a kind of partnership that we think could come out of this effort. So, in summary, why are we here and what are we hoping to accomplish? This started in 2017, and if you'd asked Scott and I and Commissioner Slaughter and others back when we first got together in the summer of 17, if we would still be talking about this, getting ready to launch in 21, we'd have said no way. It's taken a long time. But the beautiful thing is we are now at the point that we've managed a pandemic and all those things. We have a plan that we think truly can make a difference and can make this community better. And we have everybody in. You've had a whole host of groups that have already made commitments. Georgia Power has said they are in on this project. They are in financially and they are in with full support. BSU, same way. We are in financially to help support this project. And the funding that we will do as original steering committee partners would be to fund the operations of this group, hiring the director, et cetera, so that they can then get teed up to do the feasibility study, raise the funds to go out and do the project. South Georgia Medical Center, Ron Dean has said he is all in. In fact, he comes from a community that did exactly this project, just like this, and there the hospital was a big player. And we had one meeting with him. He said, of course, we're in, and we're in financially. The chamber, obviously, is in. Their board has voted to take this on. In fact, the whole community is behind it, and they will run with it, obviously, financially and in other ways. And then the Development Authority, we met with their board. Andrea and Brad have been big parts of our effort, and they took it back to the board, voted unanimously to move forward, and in fact, voted to do so at a financial commitment where they would pay all of their commitment instead of where most of us are talking about doing so over a five-year period. They decided to make their full commitment up front. Why? So that we could fully fund the first year of operations of One Bell Hostel Lounge, knowing that several of us, and I think this commission is one of them, your budget's already set for this year. So trying to create an opportunity for you to think about future budgets and how would you support that going forward. We've made a plan. We know it comes from very diverse feedback. One of the big things that we pushed with Vision First was that they truly seek the input of the whole community. We saw on a slide earlier the numbers of folks that participated in slides and participated in focus groups and individual meetings. And that diverse feedback ultimately has led to what we think is a very diverse set of ideas. Again, this is focused on economic impact, economic job growth, and it will happen here if all are in, and that's what we're trying to get accomplished. There's no question that Valdosta and Lowndes County have been on a roll coming out of COVID. In fact, our numbers, we can put them up against anyone. If we are one of the highest ranked communities literally in the country in terms of our economic success and job growth coming out of the pandemic. We want to keep that role of continuing. We want to sustain that. And long term, we think this kind of project, and again, working together and getting that next generation of workers to want to be here and to want to stay here is how we'll do that. And again, we think One Bell Hostel Lounge is how collectively we can make that happen. So with that, we will stop and be happy to take any questions.
Okay. Commissioners, any questions? No? All right. Dr. Carvajal, Mr. Purvis, we certainly appreciate your time. We appreciate, certainly from the community standpoint and from the chairman's seat. Again, I appreciate your 5 years of commitment in toting the water on this issue with all the obstacles that we've had through that process. Y'all have been steadfast. You've worked extremely hard on it, trying to pull the community together. Trying to pull the community together to where we can focus on some of these issues. As you used the terminology of silos, we use that a lot around here. We have recognized the fact that even the county and even within the county, we have a tendency sometimes to work within those silos. And we have to understand the fact that to be successful and to be more successful. We have to get outside our silos and work with other groups and pull things together to make this community as good as it can possibly be. We're good now. I mean, we're, you know, I'm as proud of this community as I can be, as you gentlemen are as well. But we still have to keep moving forward, and we have to keep making the adjustments that we need to make this community even better. So, again, I thank you, each one of you, for all your time and effort in this.
Well, Chairman, I certainly, I know I speak for Scott, and we want to thank you. From literally the very earliest days of this project, you've been all in. And it wouldn't, frankly, have happened if in those first phone calls you wouldn't have said, yeah, we want to do this. And, Paige, you have been extraordinary since coming into this position. You immediately jumped in. And have helped move us in a really, really good direction. So for the rest of you, I want you to know that the role that they have played and how they have been in getting us to this point. And now with your full support as a commission, hopefully we can now get this thing across the finish line and get it launched.
Okay. Thank you, gentlemen. Appreciate
it. Thank you all.